Hey, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jessica, and today's video is going to be my June favorites. I just kind of want to update you guys real quickly on why I haven't been filming as much as I'd like to. I have been traveling a lot for work, and I was literally gone all last week for work in Florida, and then coming up next week, I'm flying back home to see my family, so I'm gonna be gone all next week. And this weekend's just been catching up and running errands and getting stuff done. And this morning I woke up, went to the gym, then came back, went to church, ran some errands. And so I literally don't have a full face of makeup on or anything. I just wanted to film this video and get it up for you guys because I probably won't have another video up until I get back from being home. So anyways, yeah, life's just been really good and really busy, but there's always time to talk about beauty products and just kind of chit chat and catch up with you guys. So I hope you're all well, and let's just jump into it. My first favorite is my only hair item, and this is the Orbit Dry Texturizing Spray. Now, I really like this stuff. It is kind of pricey. I think it might have been 30 or 40 bucks for this bottle, but you do get a lot. There's 8.5 ounces in this bottle. And when I have very fine, soft, silky hair after it's washed, so in order for me to get my hair up into something like this and have it stay without putting a ton of product in it, I use this. Or if I just, even if it's down and I want to kind of get rid of that freshly washed feeling and give it some texture and some volume and some lift and some hold, this has been amazing. So I love this. I'm gonna take it with me on my trip next week because it's amazing. I feel like I could just air dry my hair and then spray this in the roots and throughout, and it would just give it some texture and just give it some body and life. So I really, really highly recommend this. This is awesome. I purchased this on Amazon. All right, into beauty products. My first one is from NYX. This is the Dark Circle Concealer Corrector in the color Medium. Now, this is an orangey color, and the purpose of this is to color correct if you have bluish circles. And I was noticing that no matter how much concealer I was putting on, I still felt like I had darkness or I couldn't get rid of under eye circles. And finally I was like, you know what, I need to try color correcting. So this is more of an orangey peachy shade. Orange is opposite blue, the color wheel. So if you have more blue tones, try to get an orange color like this. And it's just a really nice texture. It's creamy. I don't find that it creases, but what I do is I take this on a Real Techniques brush like this, and I just dab it in the pan, and just a little bit of product I put on first on any of my blue spots, mainly on the inner part of my eye, and a little bit up in this inner corner too, and then I'll go in and use my concealer on top of it. And I've noticed this completely makes a huge difference in getting rid of dark circles. So if you guys have that problem, this is a really, really great solution. And I have, again, the color Medium. There were different colors depending on how light or dark your skin is. The next one is then a concealer, which I have on today on top of the NYX Color Correcting. This is the Makeup Forever Full Cover Extreme Camouflage Cream Waterproof Concealer. I have this in number 6, and I love this because now that it's summer, it's really hot, we're getting sweaty, it's 115 here in Arizona, it's just ridiculously hot, and so I want something that's gonna stay and last. And next week when I'm out boating, I want something that will be able to last and stay when it's really hot. So I love this. I notice it is a little bit thicker, but I like to put it on and use the pads of my fingertips to really just warm it in and tap it into my skin. And then you can go in with your beauty blender or brush or anything just to really blend in afterwards any excess product. But I've been really, really loving this. It brightens, it sets, it doesn't, I don't notice it creasing, and it's waterproof. What else can you ask for in a mascara or in a concealer? Wow. Okay, next item is a bronzer. This is the Makeup Forever new Pro Bronze Fusion. I have it in the color 30M. I think this is the darkest color they have, but basically it looks like this. Now, before, my favorite bronzers were the NARS bronzers. I have Casino and Laguna. I liked Laguna, which is this one, when I'm not as dark, and then I got Casino when I'm a little bit more tan. This one has a tiny bit more of a reddish undertone. And these were always my go-to bronzers, but I just was noticing that they were kind of looking a little patchy when I was applying them, specifically over more dewy foundations. Even when I would set them with a powder, I still noticed I was kind of getting some patchiness going on. And so I was like, you know what, I heard about these Makeup Forever bronzers, and it's almost like a cream to powder formula. It's kind of moussey, like in the pan. You can see I've been using this a lot, and it barely even looks like I've tapped into it. But when you touch it, the formula is like, it's hard to explain. It's like a jelly powder, but it's beautiful. I love this color, and it goes on like a dream. Like, it just glides on so smooth, so soft. It's like the perfect, amount of matte and a sheen to it. So I'm just loving this. Like, literally, this has been all I've been using. I have it on today, and I just used a large brush and just like tap it in and go over the high points of my cheeks and forehead, because I didn't have time to contour and do the whole routine today. So I like to just get it on the high points like I was out in the sun, and this does the job. I really like the formula. It is amazing. Okay, next is also kind of a bronzing type product, but this is the Betty Lou Manizer bronzer and by the Balm Cosmetics. This is what it looks like. Now, this is, for me, in between a bronzer and a golden highlight color. So what I'll do is I'll first go in with a normal bronzer, and then if I'm like in a hurry or just on my way to work and I'm not doing a full face, but I want to look like I've been in the sun and I have sun-kissed glowing skin, this has been my favorite product. I like to take it, it's easy to put too much on, so you have to be careful. So I like to take a stippling brush and just like tap it in and kind of just lightly go over the high points, nose, and I kind of use this instead of a highlight for days I'm in a hurry. If you want to look extra glowing, then obviously go in with a highlight just on the very highest points. But this is amazing. If you have more of fair toned skin, then I would say you could even use this as your bronzer. It is pretty shimmery though. See how shimmery it is? I'll put it next to the other one. It's definitely more of a golden-y glow. So it is just beautiful. I love that. Especially for summer, this looks amazing if you want to look like you literally were out in the sun and you just came in and have a glow to your face. This is it. All right, the next product is a blush I've had literally forever, but since I've been traveling so much, I noticed this is the only blush I tend to pack with me because it's just an all-around good blush. This is the MAC blush in the color Peaches, and it is definitely more of a corally color, but it does have a tiny bit of a pinky undertone. If you compare it to something like Makeup Forever blush in Farta Juice, this is straight up orange. So you can see it does have a tiny bit of a pinky undertone to it, but it's still peach. So it's like, for me, it's a beautiful neutral because I tend to wear more peachy, orangey colors rather than pinks anyways, but you could go either way with this one. It's so beautiful. It's a really nice texture, and I feel like it just blends in beautifully. It's a great color, and let me see, is this a specific? This just says sheer tone blush. So, love this. It's basically my go-to a lot. All right, next two products are brow products. These are the NYX Brow Pencil and NYX Tinted Brow Mascara. I have them both in my brows today. This is all I've been using literally this whole month. Ever since I got my hands on the NYX brow pen, micro brow pencil, I've not used my Anastasio one, and it is literally a dupe for this. The color might be a tiny bit different, but they're so close that I would get this one for, I think, more than half, less than half the price of the Anastasio one. It's beautiful. So I'm gonna swatch it right here. As you can see, it's a really nice color and it's a super fine tip, just like the Anastasio one, and it's just awesome. I love it. It had been sold out in my Ulta stores. I literally went to multiple Ulta stores looking for this for weeks. I could never get my hands on it. Finally, I found it and I'm gonna stock up. I love it. And then this NYX Brow Mascara in the color Blonde. It is just like the MAC Pro Longwear Waterproof Brow Set in Empathetically Blonde. It's literally a dupe for that, I would say. This, the brush looks like this. This one, the brush is a tiny bit bigger, but I kind of like that. Like, it just, and I feel like the formula actually kind of makes the hair stay in place a little bit better. So it's just really, really nice. I love it. I can't believe that NYX is coming out with all of these dupes for amazing products that are way less expensive. So go NYX. Okay, next item are my Makeup Geek eyeshadows. I kind of went on a Makeup Geek binge shopping spree one day and literally purchased almost all of these in one sitting. So then, of course, I needed to buy a Z palette, which these are amazing. I purchased the Z palette on Amazon, and it comes with a whole bunch of magnetic backs that you can put on the back of shadows that don't have magnetism to them. So it's great, super versatile. But basically, all the ones on this side are the new Makeup Geek foiled eyeshadows. My absolute favorite go-to is this one on the top. It's like a light champagne gold color called Magic Act. It's so pretty. Like, legit, these are so pigmented. Like, look how insane that is. And they're all beautiful. I literally love putting this Magic Act. I almost started using that for the inner corner of my eye and then on my lid just to do a really fast shadow look. I have it on today, actually. And this I started using instead of my MAC shadow in the color Nylon, which is like my go-to inner corner highlight color. It's just beautiful, super creamy. These are amazing. I also really love this coppery color here. This one is called Flamethrower. This one is like holy pigmented. I mean, you barely touch your finger in there and that sucker is like, wah! And then I've really been loving mixing these colors together. This one I like putting on the bottom lash line, like the outer quarter, Showtime. And it's super, super pretty. So Showtime is like a purpley burgundy color, and I'll put it on the outer corner of my eyes, and then I'll put this one on the middle bottom and like transition into it, and it looks like this. It's like a beautiful rose gold toned color, and this one is called Grandstand. So they're amazing. I can't wait to use all of them. Let me know if you want to see anyone specifically in a makeup tutorial and I will do that for you. And then obviously I purchased some matte shadows. Probably my favorite one is Just Bitten right here. I have that on today on my bottom lash line. That's it. It's gorgeous. I feel like it makes blue-green eyes pop because it has a little bit of a reddish undertone to it, but it would look amazing literally with every eye color, I feel like. Brown eyes, anything. And then obviously a whole bunch of neutrals just to do really quick crease neutral eye looks, blending out colors, etc. So I've been loving these. They're super pigmented, just beautiful, and for the price you can't really go wrong. All right, two items left. This one is a lip liner from NYX. I must have been loving NYX this month. I mean, they just are stepping up their game, but this is my ride or die lip liner color. This is nude beige number 857. Now I've repurchased this color over and over and over. I think this is my fourth one and I couldn't find it. It was literally sold out in all the Ulta stores everywhere and I couldn't find it online. Like, it was ridiculous. But in the fact that I couldn't find it made me realize how much I used it. It's literally like my exact lip color, maybe one shade darker. And so I line my lips almost every day with this, no matter what color I have on top of it. Like, I have it on today with this shade, and this is obviously not a neutral shade. This is more of a corally color. So this is just so pretty. It's like the best neutral lip color ever. It's not too warm and it's not too cool. So it's amazing. And the formula of these are so good. All right, last favorite is a food item. As you know, I'm also really into fitness, and my absolute favorite protein bar are the Quest bars. If you guys haven't heard of these, they're so legit. This is my favorite flavor. It's cookies and cream. They have a whole bunch of different flavors, and this is my absolute favorite. So if you have a sweet tooth and you are really wanting something either on the go or even at home, I highly recommend these. I mean, it's to the point of where I buy them by the box. Yeah, I have a problem. But what I do is I take these out, put them on a little plate. I spray it with a little tiny spray of Pam first, otherwise it can stick to the plate. And then I put it in the microwave for literally 12 seconds or 15 seconds. And it, after you take it out, and it tastes like a warm, between a chocolate chip cookie and an Oreo. And then sometimes, like, I'll measure out 1 tablespoon of peanut butter, or I'll break it up and put it on my Quest or on my Arctic Zero ice cream. It's like a healthy alternative ice cream. And it's my favorite. It's literally what I eat every single night. Half of one of these and that dessert thing, or a whole one of these if I'm on the go. They're just perfect to throw in your purse. So anyways, that is everything. Those are my favorites for the month of June. I'm so excited. Next month is July. It's my brother's birthday, so I get to see him when we go home. And I just love being on the water and on the boats to see all the fireworks for the 4th of July. So I hope you guys all have a happy 4th and hug your family and friends and just be thankful for what the holiday means, Independence Day. And we're just so lucky to live in this country. And I'm gonna stop rambling now. So anyways, I hope you have a fabulous day. And until next time, I'll see you in my next video. Peace.